here we are. We are in the Lock Lift.
Come on.
With LaRusso, Tieta.
Come on.
Hey, thank you, first of all, for being a part of the Lock Lift.
Of course.
And before we even, like, super go forward, I have to give you a... I told you before, because I got a chance to come out to the pergola.
Yeah.
Which was super, super dope. But I pulled Tieta, I pulled you aside. I was like, hey, man, the information that y'all be giving online, like, people take things lightly. And I've been in the game for a minute. Mm. But I'm always learning. And one thing, you know, the things that you were saying about content and utilizing your content, it inspired me to take the Lock Lift even further.
Love it.
You know what I mean? And really, really utilize it. So I want to thank both of y'all for providing that. So up and coming artists, you know, if you come in it, you have no excuses.
Right.
You need to, you know what I mean? Like, we're giving away game. They're giving away game. You need to soak that up. So thank you, you know what I mean, for that. And thank you for being a part of the Lock Lift.
Come on.
So first question I got for you, LaRusso. Well, it's more of a comment, and I want you to expand on it. The first thing that drew me to you, because I had been a little bit familiar with you before when you was going by your other name,
Tota,
a little bit. Yeah, Tota. But then I start seeing you moving around more and more, and I still was like, okay, he dope. But then you just start really exploding with all your content. But the thing that drew, you know, for me as an artist, I was really drawn to your lyricism, your songwriting.
Come on.
Can you speak a little bit on that, and what's the inspiration behind your lyricism, your songwriting? How did you develop that, or where does that come from?
Man, it comes through repetition mostly. I remember when I first started really, like, writing raps, I never used to be able to write songs or verses that made sense.
Mm-hmm.
I just wrote bars. Yeah, I just had a notebook full of bars. Every line was a punchline. Literally, how niggas be hearing my shit today and be like, he don't take a break. It's because when I first started, I only wrote bars. I couldn't write a song. Yeah. Like, it'll be a whole song with just bars that didn't make sense about nothing, and then a hook.
So you was just rapping.
I was just rapping. Yeah. But that's how I learned how to rap. And then eventually, when I got to a point where I wanted to really be me and tell my story, I had to really learn how to formulate a song, how to communicate what I'm feeling, right? Mm-hmm. But still, you know, still make it bars and cool. But now I never really try to write bars anymore. Mm-hmm. I just write, and how I speak now is just how that shit be coming out.
Yeah. It becomes, I feel like for me, your style is very conversational too. You know what I mean? And that's the type of thing, like you could turn it up when you want to turn it up. You know what I mean? But I think the thing that resonates with me is probably a lot of other people out there, your audience, is that it's very conversational. It's like an interview. Like
we're having a talk, right?
Yeah.
Right.
I think that's very appealing to people, and it's digestible. How often are you writing? Is it just a feeling, or do you kind of, like, you know, make a schedule, or do you kind of...
Man, I don't write and record very, very often, but mm-hmm. I do it, like, in bunches. So mm-hmm. when I am in a studio for whatever, I'm doing, like, 5, 6, 7 songs. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm doing a bunch in those moments. But I'm always, like, reading things off and on and writing in my phone, like, little life gems.
Yeah.
But I don't really write music until...
Wait, can you expand on that? When you said you write things on your phone...
So in my phone, I have a
because
folder.
Because I want to see if you do the same thing that I do sometimes.
In my phone, I have a folder called gems. Look, just this morning, I had a thought, and I wrote it down. It says, I want to be a billionaire too, just a bit more ethically. I'm not trying to sell crack to the kids. It ain't nothing wrong with having some paper. How you get the paper and what you do with the paper says more than having the paper. That was my morning thought, and I wrote it
so
down.
So it ain't even necessarily raps. It's just ideas and thoughts and feelings.
Yeah, like throughout the day, I don't really write raps. Mm-hmm. I just write life stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday, I wrote let come what may. Remember we was in the truck? That's what I was trying to tell you. Mm-hmm. I had read something that said let come what may. Right, we always wish for a specific life, but the warrior way of living life is like, let come what may, and I'ma deal with it so it can strengthen me, you know?
That's fine.
But that's really, I just write life things throughout the day, and then when it's time to rap, sometimes they come back.
They come
to
back.
Me and,
yeah. That's crazy because I do something similar, but I just use the voice recorder.
Mm.
You know what I mean? But I'm a little bit more direct with I'm thinking like, ooh, that's gonna be a fireball.
See, I like to write shit because mm-hmm. it activates all three senses. Like when you mm-hmm. write it, you write, that's one sense. Mm-hmm. You see it, that's another sense. Mm-hmm. And then you have to say it in your head. So that's three mm-hmm. senses. Mm-hmm. That's why like I'm able to remember verses. Like I be rapping hella songs yeah. during the show. Yeah, and people absolutely. Like, how the fuck you know? But it's because I've seen it, mm-hmm. I've heard it, and I wrote it. Like mm-hmm. I touched it too many
so
times.
So many different
to
ways.
Know it,
yeah.
Right?
Wow, that's amazing. Yeah, now that's great. The next thing I wanted to ask you, and this, you know, Tieta, you can chime in on this too, is like the content. You know, as somebody that's been in the game for a minute, and I've steadily been putting out music, but technology, the way we consume music, things are constantly changing. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? Whether it's streaming, whether it's, you know what I mean? Whether it's on social media, you know what I mean? At one point in time, it was blogs, you know what I mean? And right. I noticed, like, just as me being in the game, it's like you always have to be fluid in how you move and how you market your music. And a lot of times, the marketing and the art are integrated, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And I feel like you do that very well. How conscious of you are that, and how do you balance it, and how do y'all come with ways to strategize when you put it out?
My content. And I've been making content a long time. Mm-hmm. And I've been at a point where I was making content for other people and helping build things. And one day I had to decided I was only going to make content that I love and enjoy.
Wait, I just want to ask you something. You said you were making content for other people?
Yeah, like I used to film. I've done photography, filming, editing, just for everything,
so
for
you
everyone.
You touched all these different
right?
things.
Right,
okay.
And I decided I was only going to do things I love to do. And after that, I figured out a bunch of ways. How can I make content that allows me to do what I already do? I already rap. So mm-hmm. if all I got to do is get on camera and rap to go viral and change my life, that's an easy call.
That's easy.
You don't like, you don't have to overthink content. If you rap, go rap, nigga. That's right. All, like, you get in this car and you rap.
Exactly.
That's how you going to go viral because that's what you're great at. Exactly. That's how I look at content. And when I was coming up, the niggas that I shot with and spent money with and knew what companies was the ones who had commercials and the ones who had advertising.
Facts.
Your content is just your commercial for your brand. Facts. If you got more commercials, people gonna see you more. Mm-hmm. I got hella different commercials because I don't just do one thing. Mm-hmm. So you might see me doing
so you
hella
constantly
different
creating,
shit.
You constantly creating promotion.
I'm constantly living.
Yeah.
And nigga, when I get up and I say some shit, if a nigga caught on camera, it's like, bro, we go viral for me just saying it's different. Get your ass up, grow. And I was
that's
doing
constant.
That anyway. I won because
I didn't have to
think too deep or go out of my zone. When I rehearsed, like my favorite time was rehearsing in a garage. That's how we really start going viral.
I've
and it
that.
Was like, bro, we just in here doing what we do every day. We let the world see it, and now you get to go. So yeah, my thing with content is live and take the pieces out of your living.
Tieta, you have anything? Because I know you're very much involved in the social media and as well as other things. You have anything else that you contribute? How you add to that?
No, I think he hit it. Right on the head. It's just like the easiest way to get content done is to film what you're already doing.
Mm-hmm.
Your life is your content model, and then once you're shooting the content. I think the next step is just be really
what she
organized.
Said, your life.
Your life is
your
content
model. Wow.
Yeah.
Come on.
And then just be really organized with it. I feel like once you get to the point where you're shooting content all the time, like you knocked out the most difficult part, right? You got the content done. And then now the next step is like organizing it in a way that makes sense to getting it out. So like figure out your model of editing. So you break down the long form into the pieces that you love, and then you get those ones into like social media form for YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, and then just send them out.
But to start, you ain't even gotta do, just take your phone and your stand. This nigga Lethal Shooter will go and shoot a shot from the end, and then from out of nowhere on his phone, make it and post it, and it's
viral.
So it's like sometimes you get too colluded and having this, just that, and it's like, bro, just go shoot something.
Yeah.
You feel me? Especially, like I said, don't go out your way, but if you already doing things, if you already going to the studio and you're an artist, film, it be niggas on their phone in the studio all day.
Yeah.
Ain't no content
ain't
coming
no
out.
Content come out.
How does that make sense?
Right. Right.
Nah, I want to. One of the things that you said too, I feel like for me personally, that has worked so well, is like you said, organizing your shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the gems that I got from y'all Free Game Friday. You was like, I kept hearing, it's like, yeah, I use the scheduler, I do this, I do that, and I was like, you know what? I was like, fuck, I'm gonna try this shit. You know what I mean? Like, I'm a, right. And show enough, like, I'm posting content. I gotta, you know, I'll take one day a week, schedule it out, and then I still post stuff randomly within. Exactly. But I still got these 7 posts that's for show coming Bro, out throughout the week.
And right. that's, man, that's right. what changed everything. Like, we realized, right, you can't just have scheduled posts. You got to have shit that's real time, that's real too. Like, niggas want to see you in the real world to know your page ain't just automated.
Right.
Right? Mm-hmm. But, yeah, having things that you know is going to happen, it ain't never easy. No wrong with yeah, that. You feel me? Right. Then you just adding things. You don't have to be scrambling to get shit up. Like, yeah. It changes everything.
It changes everything. And another jewel that I feel like, that you guys have been stressing.
That's a big ass bird.
Damn. Was that a hawk? An eagle?
Motherfucker is big.
Streets of North Vallejo, man. But another thing that y'all said is shooting multiple forms of content for whatever song that you're using.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, I feel like that has been such a difference maker. I mean, that's why, hence, we doing the lock lift. You know, this was something I was already doing, but then when I heard y'all talk about it, I was like, you know what? They got a good point. I need to lean into this shit more. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because as soon as I did that, I start seeing the instant results. Bro, like, instantly.
Every song you have should have pillars, right?
Facts.
In different formats. Niggas heard do that little dance. Mm-hmm. They ain't hear it in the lock lift with exact, that beat.
Exactly.
You feel it's me? A different, and it's that a... might be the one that gets you to become a fan of LaRussell.
Exactly.
So it's like, I'm using this one thing to create me 10 different avenues. Like, you got to spread it. You got to spread it.
You got to, man. And I don't know if you had this early on, you know, when you were posting multiple contents, but did you ever have, like, fans or people like, man, why are you posting the same song over and over again? Did y'all ever get that shit?
I only get that if I do it the same exact way okay. over and over. Uh-huh. But with me, it's like, you gonna hear it in somebody, you might hear it with a saxophone today, and you like, nigga, right. what the fuck was that? You might hear it with a violin one day. Yeah, yeah. You might see me in the back of a truck another day, you feel me? So, like, people only get that when you're giving them the same shit. And it's like, of course, you don't wanna wake up and eat the same fucking breakfast every day if you don't have to.
Facts, facts. Facts.
You feel me?
We do it in different settings. So different even settings. If you're doing like it over the same beat, mm-hmm. and you don't have a pianist or a saxophone or something, like, just change your environment.
Change the background. Go outside for one.
Come into the lock lift.
Do it, man. There's so many different ways to deliver that song, and sometimes, like, you need to be on that song because it's one of them ones, but people not hearing it enough. Yep. So it's like, every time I make a track, I tell the homies, I be like, think of 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 different ways that we can mark this. And do a piece of content.
Yes.
I literally, for Don't Make Me Get My Belt, stood on top of my roof and put the bike up
there,
and the
crazy.
Motherfucker did $500,000.
That's
you
crazy.
Feel me? So it's like, it's as simple as that. Find different ways. When you listen to the song, what visually does it bring in your mind? Bring that shit to life.
And what I started to do now, since he has so many songs, right? And then he'll perform this song maybe at every single show 10 different times, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then we started scheduling it out to where that song will get posted once a month. So how you were saying pre-schedule stuff,
it's like,
little dance is going to be shown on his page once every single month because mm-hmm. he's done it so many times.
Mm-hmm.
And then now the next time you do like your second favorite song, do it 10 different ways and post that once every 2 weeks. And then now all of a sudden you got 10 songs that you love and you've done it 10 different ways.
In the span of a year, they've heard that song 10 times, 10 different ways, so they can become a fan of it, but not annoyingly. I don't want to see it every fucking day.
But I'll see it every 2 weeks.
But I'll see it every three weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
That's dope, man.
And you have it pre-made now.
So. It's basically like a television channel. Yep. It's just like you're showing.
This is my network.
It's just like, hey, look, I ain't gonna play the same movie, but you gonna see this movie. It's gonna come again. You gonna see it in about 2-3 weeks.
You gonna see Will Smith in a lot of shit, but it's a different movie, but it's still Will Smith. So you get to become a fan of Will Smith, but you get to see him in different variations. You get to see him in minute. It's not like Liam Neeson. You see Liam Neeson, that nigga got the same shit. But if you love it, you with it.
You with it every single time.
Yeah. I'm seeing everyone. But with Will, it's like, oh shit, he in this too?
Yeah.
It's a whole different
one
Will.
One day he's Serena Williams' daddy. The next day he fighting a robot.
Exactly, right. Bro. You can't. That's the type of spread you want, though, for your brand. It's Facts. Like, yeah, I'm this, but you can see me in different
Especially
variations.
Especially when you're versatile. You want to show people at every
Man, if you got it,
yeah.
if you got it,
Facts.
Yeah.
If you got it, give it. If you got it, give it.
Yeah, yeah. Now, it's with y'all, with the information that y'all giving is very, very important. Before we get out of here, I do want to ask you, how do you keep your balance? Because y'all constantly moving. I know you're constantly elevating, you're constantly growing your brand, you're working. How do you keep the balance managing between the road? Because I remember even last week I hit you like, bro, we so busy. I need a couple days to rest. Right. Like, what are you doing? How are you conscious of that, and how do you balance that? Because that's a lot of work.
That's how, by telling people no every now and then. Like, you feel me? Like, and everyone respect it. Like, you like, oh, for sure. Like, that's an understandable request. Absolutely. But that's something that I do now. Like, I will tell people, like, bruh, I'm taking a day off more often now than not. Coney told me one time, he was like, you one of the only niggas I know who'd be like, I'm taking a day. You feel me? But I do that. And on those days, I go walk or I play pickleball. I chill with my daughter. Or I just chill with the homies. I take shrooms. I do whatever I need to do to kind of
get balance.
Yeah, get back in that space, because it's like, I don't want my life to change. Like, you feel me? I'm happy I made it here and I'm able to go move the world. So it's just finding that middle ground. And everybody's balance point is different. Like, I noticed I could go a long time before I need a real break. You feel me? But finding that balance point that works for you. And I've been finding it. And luckily for me, just being home is kind of like a recharge. Mm-hmm. Like, when I'm home, I get that recharge, and I get to go back out into the world after.
You just got to listen to how you feeling. Like, that's really man. It. However you feel in that day, you should go with. And if you love what you're doing, you always going to come back to it. So you don't got to stress it too much if you took 3, 4, 5 a week off. Because when you come back, you're going to be better. You're going to be better.
You take a step back so you can take care of more business.
If you love it, you always going to find your way back to it.
Facts, man. Well, then that's a great way to end it, man. I appreciate y'all for being a part of this Lock Lift. This shit was hella fun.
This was great.
This was super dope. And,
this is great.